Both teams are lining up for the kickoff. We're just about set to get this one underway. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Huskies and their ground game's always been sensational. It's not always one guy, Herbie. Sometimes they've got two or three that can carry the load.
And that's what makes it so tough for this defense, is you're not focusing in on just one guy. You're focusing in on really an entire scheme. And because of that diversity, I think it makes it more of a challenge. And you got to be better tacklers in the open field. And I think that's really what they've stressed all week, is tackling and gang tackling and getting to the football.
It's hard to get to guys and make tackles in space. From their own 35-yard line. First down.
Red two.
Setting up the play action. Fires quickly, and it's picked off. And down he goes. Right around the 48-yard line. And the quarterback just can't believe it. He really wishes he could have that one back.
Every quarterback has passes that he wishes he could have back. However, hey, a pick is a pick, and no one is going to care how bad he wants that one back.
First and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. Run left, and he's taken down in the backfield.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established, and for such a negative play to happen, loss of yards, it can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain. 7 yards there on that bit of misdirection. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Tackle made around the 41-yard line. The screen pass goes nowhere.
Well, you got to take your hat off to the defense. All week they preached over and over again how they were not going to let this kid use his speed in the open field, and they really shut him down that time.
He's tackled at the 32. Another run. They'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback. The cavalry's coming. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
North Carolina State could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks up, and it's good. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. NC State's in the driver's seat right now, but it's still early, Kirk.
Yep, very early in this game, but you got to love the feel for it as far as they're concerned. They came up with a stop, and then they get points, and right now they're out of the game.
You know the offense will be looking to do better this time out.
He's got a lot of time to forget about that last pick. He just got to stick to the game plan.
And he's taken down the 27-yard line. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down.
Dog four.
He gets rid of this one.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
He showed you right there why a defense can never lose tabs on it. Take your eye off him in coverage, and he'll create a big play.
From their own 39-yard line, it's first down. He's taken down at the 41. And once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on third down. And he's tackled around the 49-yard line. He really got a hold of that one. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. The offense goes back out onto the field after picking up a field goal on their last drive. North Carolina State holds a field goal lead. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Great concentration to haul it in.
Here's the true test of a quarterback at any level. Can they make a good throw under pressure when one or two or three guys are coming right at him? I think this young passer has proven that, yes, he can.
Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. From their own 36-yard line, second down. The throw, incomplete pass. Out of bounds at the 43. I wouldn't be surprised if this one is offensive pass interference.
Pass interference.
Nice gain, but not enough for the first down.
Yeah, that's a nice play there. They did everything right except get enough yards for the first down.
The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Well, this has really been stingy by both of these defenses. And the question is, can they keep this pace up, though?
I think that's a big challenge for them to be able to continue to play like this. Right now, the emotion of the game is favoring the two defenses. But I get a feeling it's a matter of time until one of these offenses starts clicking.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. There's a strike complete. He's to the 20. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 22-yard line.
What we're seeing right now is just a great connection between the quarterback and his receivers. They make these plays look effortless.
From their own 22-yard line, first down.
Black five, black five, blue four. Blue four.
Zips it to the tight end.
He showed some excellent moves out there. More than you usually expect from a tight end. That was a big gain, and this offense keeps humming along.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 41. Throws out to the tight end again, completes. And he hits him hard at the 39.
That's great execution. Quarterback made a nice throw, and the receiver was able to go up and make the play.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line.
Here we go.
And he shoved out of bounds right around the 36-yard line. After a quarter of play, we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. 3-0, North Carolina State. Back to the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point. Down at the 35. A one-yard gain by the halfback.
Good job by the junior linebacker to read the run and limit the play to a short gain.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 29.
Green nine, green.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Knocked out of bounds at the 21.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. First down.
Tight right. Solo out there. Check the outs out there. Four down. 43 is the mic. Go!
Inside the 10. And they make the stop at about the 7-yard line. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. At the 4-yard line. This is the ninth play of this drive. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. Here we go, folks. Third and goal from the 4. Room around the corner. That's a great tackle at the 7. Connecticut is looking to tie things up. It's up, and it is good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And they can forget about returning this one. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Strike to his receiver, no good.
Brad, this corner just made a great play on the football. You wonder if he's starting to maybe get into the mindset of this quarterback, and maybe the quarterback's going to look in the other direction to try to come up with a completion.
They come out on an empty backfield. Got it, and brought down immediately. Scrambling around. And down he goes to the 38-yard line. Out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 36.
That's a loss of 7 yards. That brings up third and 12.
So we're looking at another third down here.
Hey, check mic 33. Check mic 33.
Bring it.
He sails it long. The senior makes the catch. And he is drilled at the 30. Catches it, and he's looking for more.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
And he's level at the 11-yard line.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
Incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
And this is the 10th play of the drive.
Mike check 33.
And they'll get him in the backfield.
Loss of 2 yards on the play.
They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two.
Set! Ready!
And a man open touchdown! Hits the PAT. It was an 11-play, 76-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
You know, when you can throw the football as well as these guys can, you don't necessarily always have to have a balanced attack because you're so proficient in throwing the ball.
So the score now, 10-3. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Well, really a defensive battle going on right now so far, Kirk.
Well, the defenses are flying around the football, doing a good job. I think both offenses are making it a little easier because of their style of game plan. I think if I were the offensive coordinator, I'd take a few chances. Be willing to open it up and try to give your quarterback a chance to make a play.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And they push him out right around the 40. First down grab. First and 10, ball on the 40-yard line. And he just gets rid of it. Got it with room to run. Tackle made at the 49-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. They keep it on the ground, and a great tackle right there. Picked up a yard, if anything, on that run. NC State's going to have to use their second time out of the half. The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. And this one is a beauty. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
Well, I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And one thing is that any defensive coordinator would tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
From their own 17-yard line, second down, North Carolina State is up by a touchdown.
Set! Green 19! Green 19! Hut, hut!
steps out of bounds around the 23-yard line. From their own 23-yard line, it's third down. Makes it out to about the 33.
A nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there and one of his guys can come down with it. It's intercepted. Points were very hard to come by in those first two quarters. They'll head to the locker room. The Wolfpack lead 10-3.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. Things are straight defensive out there right now. David, what do these two offenses have to do to open this game up?
Well, it's fun to watch because obviously I'm a defensive guy and I enjoy this, but when your defense is executed at that kind of level, the offense has to be precise. I mean, you got to throw it in tight windows. You got to be willing to take some chances that you normally wouldn't have. How about some trick plays, maybe? I mean, when you're losing the battle in the trenches, you got to find some way to kind of even it out. Maybe get a little bit more options, some reverses, some double passes, something to loosen up this defense. Because right now, defenses are just winning out.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. And he got all of this one. Great kick. Quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. North Carolina State is up a score. And he's taken down at the 38. Decent run here, right side. He gets hit out of bounds, the 39-yard line.
That's a gain of 13. That makes it first and 10.
Makes it out to about the 29. Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. They get a 1 yard loss on that one.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
That'll bring up second and 11.
From the 30-yard line, second down.
Hey, check mic 33, check mic 33.
I'm gonna run.
Ready!
Get to that quickly. North Carolina State up 7 points. and he's hit before he can go anywhere. They just took what the defense gave them on that play.
Yeah, you're right. That was a good job of getting that pass completed for positive yardage.
Touchdown, North Carolina State. Pitch it as the quarterback's able to run it in.
I'll tell you what, when you're a quarterback and the goal line is right there, it's pretty hard to pitch the ball when you think you can get in. That's a smart decision to keep it for the score.
And he tacks on the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Throws complete. He's got space to work. And he's tackled right around the 38-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. First down.
Check. Tight right. Solo out there. Check the outs out there.
Here we go.
Green, go. 15. Go.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Around 5 yards on the delayed handoff. Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 43.
Quads. Check four. Hey, we heavy on the edges. Easy.
He's tackled at the 49.
Gain of 6 yards. That makes it first and 10.
He's taken down at the 41. From the 41-yard line, first down.
Dog four.
And he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
They'll bring him down around the 33-yard line.
Gain of 8 yards. That makes it.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. He makes it to the 32-yard line.
This is a good call by the defensive coordinator. He guessed run. When the offense came with it, his guys were in position to make the stop.
Pickup. Here's play number 10 on the drive.
Three down.
43 is the mic.
Here we go. X.
The ball pops free. They fall on it. That's a pretty big mistake, and this offense will lose possession of the football.
Sloppy job by the ball carrier. First and foremost, you should always be concerned about the ball.
And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down. So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep. Those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
It's second down, five to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. He's knocked out of bounds at the 17-yard line. Tackle at about the 3-yard line. They line up in the jumbo set. Here's a pitch, left side. Touchdown, Huskies. And he converts the extra point. So a 12-play, 67-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. The score now, 17-10. They line up to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. The Huskies have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. North Carolina State is up 7. Makes it out to about the 36. Strike complete.
That's a deep four run play. That makes it second and six.
Take him down immediately. That's a nice 6-yard gain.
Well, he really didn't have to do too much there to give himself a little room to make the catch.
And down he goes at the 47. Some open field, and they make the stop at the 41-yard line. Hang on tight, folks. We head to the fourth quarter in what could be a shocker. 17-10, Wolfpack. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter.
Mic check, 33.
And off up the middle, and he's stuffed. From the 43-yard line, it's second down. North Carolina State is up by a touchdown. Brought down to the 42-yard line. A very impressive open field tackle. Fourth down. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. Kicks up, and he just drilled it from long range. Kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. Last drive ended with as good a result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
gets out to about the 35-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. And they back up 3 yards on that play.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
He's got room to work. Tackle made at the 43.
It's a smart job here by the coaches, making a play call here that really played to their offensive strengths. That's knowing your personnel.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he's taken down at about the 33-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Fires it out. Has some daylight. And a huge touchdown play. Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. And he hits the PAT. A seven-play, 76-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Run there.
That makes it second and six.
Mike check 33. 33.
Let hot.
Makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Connecticut will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. From their own 30-yard line. Third down. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Just throws this one away.
Easy, easy, easy. Lucky 95. Lucky 95.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. He really got a hold of that one. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. The Huskies coaching staff and the entire team knows that this is the guy that can win it for them.
The offense has to find a way to get the football into the hands of this running back, whether it's a simple toss sweep or maybe a ball out of the backfield where he can catch it in space. Any way that they can get the football to him to see if he can spring one or maybe get the field goal range, or who knows, maybe take it to the house.
And he's tackled around the 38-yard line. Throwing right. Great catch, and he's out of bounds.
First down.
Initially, it was called a catch, but now we're going to find out for sure if he at least had 1 foot in and possession of the ball before he went out of bounds.
After review of the play, The ruling on the field is reversed.
So after the review, they reversed the call on the field. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He's tackled around the 46-yard line.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want them.
First down. A little over a minute in the game.
Black, kill. Panther 2.
And he throws right away. And that just might do it. Intercepted. He steps up and makes a big turnover.
Yeah, he just made a huge play right there. He knew what was coming all along.
From their own 23-yard line, it's first down.
Oklahoma
makes it out to about the 33. This guy just made those 10 yards look easy. The Huskies are going to call their second timeout. He's on the run. He makes his way to about the 45.
He got the ball, and he was off like a shot. This guy has some big-time speed.
From their own 45-yard line, first down. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. He takes a knee. So this one goes final. A hard-fought, close game. 2017 Wolfpack. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.